Hello everyone, welcome back. Thank you so much for joining me. So it's Monday. Hi, happy Monday. Listen, what a week it was last week. It's so I just hope everyone is okay, everyone has taken a moment to step away from social media. As much as it's important to keep on top of everything, it's also important to take a step back, even if it's half an hour, the night, you know, and just step away and let your mind kind of come to terms with everything, because the world is shit. That's it. So our hopefully stories today can take your mind and my mind away from the real world just for a few moments. So I'm hoping everything is looking okay. I'm trying out a new camera, a new system. Listen, how crazy is technology? I didn't realize that memory cards you put in your camera can help the quality of your video. It's crazy. So luckily I've had some help and everything's fine and I'm learning and I'm doing. So today is today and we died. Oh, that reminds me, if you've never been here before on a Monday, Mondays are when I read my subscribers' ghost stories. So if you have a ghost story, a paranormal experience, weird experience, yeah, send them right here to this email address and I will read them out here on Mondays. Videos. This video series is very much based on Bailey Sarin's Murder, Mystery and Makeup Mondays, so go ahead and check her out if you're not already. I'm sure you're very familiar with her. I'll leave a link as always below to her channel. So this week's way of dying is I'm just over it. I'm just fucking over it, and I just sat there like this for the rest of my life because I'm so over it that I'm just like, you know what, fuck everyone, this is me now, I'm done. And I sat there and I just gathered dust. And that's what we're doing. We are doing dusty look. So I got a really nice package the other day, which I really wasn't expecting. Sydney Grace sent me some amazing product. They sent me some palettes which are really, really nice. Look at those colors here. And they sent me loads of individual colours as well, which I put in my empty magnetic palettes. Look at these greens. I like these highlightery things as well. And they also sent me loads of, I actually need to look at what they are, but some lip products and then some like cream. I think they're cream eyeshadows, but I need to look into them. So thank you to them. I'm going to use them today just to try them out and see what happens. So I've hydrated my skin quite a bit. However, I do need a little bit more help, but I don't want my skin to be oily. So I'm using my ColourPop Watermelon Face Milk. I love these face milks because they're hydrating enough, but not too much. And by the way, that's a rip in my shirt that I ordered from ASOS and it came with a rip. And I don't like to return things because I'm really impatient. So maybe I'll sew it up, maybe I won't. Oh, I forgot to mention as well, you can send your ghost story in any format that you like. You can do it by, you know, email, just a normal email. Well, you have to email anyway, you know what I mean? Writing, you can do it in an audio clip if you like to. We are kind of running low on audio clips and they really help me out. Or you can even send in a video clip of yourself reading your story if you want to. Or even if you're like a narrator and you want me to send you a story to read out on here, that would be very much appreciated. Okay, let's do it. Dusty as fuck and died. So I'm reading from quite, my setup is a little bit different now, whereas usually I have what I'm reading would be here next to me. It's now here, but my mirror's here. But I have a monitor here. So I'm hoping I can see what I'm doing and read at the same time. Okay, so our first story today is called Fishbone Bridge. So it says, hi Robert, I love your videos. I have to thank you also because you make my Mondays so much better. Thank you, and thank you for watching these videos because they make my Mondays so much better also. My story is set in the summer of 2017. This was a year that I took off to help my mother take care of sick relatives. However, this is about the times I spent with my two nieces. One had come to spend the summer from Florida. I was 24 at the time, and my nieces were 14 and 13. Great ages for scaring. I have always been the fun aunt because I am the younger of the siblings. There would be times when I would take them to do something so my mum could rest or do what needed to be done with relatives. On one such occasion, we were driving around the back roads when we came across a very old bridge on the outskirts of town. Naturally, we decided to park my car and get out and investigate. Bridges can be really haunted, don't do that. The bridge had a train track running under it. I was studying to be an MUA slash photographer at the time and wanted to scope out the bridge for a picture location. After being on the bridge for a while, we came back to the car when I noticed there were fish bones all over the ground. There were heavily wooded areas surrounding the bridge, with only one clearing on the far left where we parked. There was no water that I could see close by until we got about half a mile up the road, and there was a relatively large pond on the other side. The fishbone struck me as odd, yeah. For one reason, they didn't look clean, like how you would clean a fish to prepare it to cook. No, these had been ripped up and still had chunks of flesh and skin. I know that a lot of animals in Oklahoma eat fish, but usually they won't eat them in the open like where I saw the bones. So that begs the question, how in the hell did all those fish bones end up so far from the water? And what the hell happened to them? This was early in the day, and as we got to the car, the oldest turned to me and said, "Did you feel weird?" I asked her what she meant, and she said, "It felt like we were being watched." She and I share the love of the creepy and the spooktacular, so of course we wanted to go back. Why are you doing this? It took me some convincing to get my other niece to go back, but we all decided to go back in the evening. When we returned, I headed for the bridge first, and I could almost swear I could feel someone looking at me from the left side of the bridge that's closest to the clearing. I walked back towards the car where the girls were. I walked along the edge of a road. This is also where I found two more things. More fish bones. And $120. I had just started to tell them when my older niece called out she found an old building tucked into the trees. Before she could get any closer to it, there was a loud, piercing scream. We all heard it and ran for the car. As we reversed out, we all screamed, and I completely forgot there was money in my hand as I tried to get the hell out of there. We tried to find information on that bridge and the area around it, but couldn't find anything. We really don't know what that scream was. I promise it was loud and creepy. If all three of us hadn't heard it or felt the same feelings, I would chalk it up to just us looking for weird things. It was unmistakable that all of us felt something out there. I know that finding money out there suggests a human presence, but it did not sound human at all. That scream was otherworldly. None of us had ever heard anything like it before. Something odd is out there, whether human, animal, or something in between. The bridge has since been torn down. Clearing was turned into a part of the road. We haven't gone back there since. Not sure if I want to. I most certainly would not. Listen, I have to, two things. I have to congratulate you on going back and like exploring, but at the same time, I'm like, look after yourself, that's so dangerous. Money, what, that money was a trap. And like, whatever it was, like humans like money. I'll leave $120. Who carries around that much cash though? I would love, oh no, maybe I wouldn't, I don't know. I've definitely gone to like some places that are meant to be like a little bit haunted or creepy, and then nothing ever happens, and it's kind of disappointing, but at the same time, it's like, oh, maybe we're lucky nothing happened. So we're gonna skip ahead a little bit quicker than usual, and we have Marcus reading us a story. Where's my camera? There. Marcus, take it away.
Hello, Robert. Here are two stories read from people who sent them in by email to your email.
This first one's called Bad Neighborhood. Hi Robert, I love your videos. I've been watching your ghost stories and makeup videos and been obsessed. I also love the way you do makeup and you have taught me so much about it, so thank you. This was very recent, about 2 months ago. Me and my boyfriend went on a date. Well, that night my parents were at a party, so they didn't mind if I stayed out late as well, as long as I kept in touch with them and came back home. So me and my boyfriend go on the date to his house and watch scary movies because I'm such a huge horror movie lover. When it was time for me to go home, my boyfriend gave me a lift, but things were very off. As we were on our way to my house, there was not a single car moving, which was very weird considering that where I live, it's always very busy. It was about 7:30 p.m. and it was pitch black outside. There was no street lights on. The only lights that were on were the traffic lights or the traffic signals. A little backstory on my neighbourhood. There has been people murdered, kidnapped and robbed in many houses, and both my neighbours do not like my family, considering we're another race, and me and my sister are part of the LGBTQ community, and my neighbours are homophobic. As we began to pull up on the driveway, I swear that I saw a very tall man in my backyard. The thing that caught my attention most were his eyes. They were red and he was much taller and slender, but he vanished as soon as he saw a car pull up. I told my boyfriend that he believed me, so he told his parents he was going to stay late with me. As we got into the house, my dog was barking and crying down the stairs, and Alexa was playing the song Tiptoe Through the Tulips by Tiny Tim. Obviously, we thought my brother was trying to prank me, but no one was in the house. Then we heard a door slam, the windows break, and the car alarm go off. I was absolutely shitted. So my boyfriend went upstairs to check. He noticed that my back door was now in a bad shape and it couldn't close. The kitchen window was shattered. He turned off the car alarm and called the cops. When the cops arrived, we told them everything we experienced and they investigated the house. They found a gun buried in the backyard and a sledgehammer on the floor with blood on it. They predicted that the man, who I probably saw, was a criminal and was trying to bury a body in my backyard and hide his evidence in my house. He might even have been trying to kill us when we got back there. Up to this day, I have nightmares and trouble sleeping, considering I'm the only one who sleeps upstairs. But thankfully, my parents bought a new house and we're currently moving. Well, that's good news. I'm glad you're getting out of that neighbourhood. Christ. The second story is called The Doll in the Car. Hi, Robert. I've been watching you for a long time now and I just love your videos and your overall energy. I was about 11 and my friend and I were having a sleepover. I've always loved horror movies, as did the friend I was with, so we chose to watch Chucky, a classic of course. After the movie was over, I began to feel an odd presence, like something was off. My friend said they also experienced the same thing. Later on that day, we left my house to get some snacks for later on that night, and the feeling continued. As we were walking back to my house, I saw an unusual looking car with a Chucky doll in the back seat, staring at us. I'd never seen the car before. The doll looked beaten up, with dirt across its face, hair dishevelled, clothes completely ripped. It had a sinister aura to it, like it was capable of causing harm. We tried walking around the car, but it felt like its eyes were watching us, following us. The same feeling we had both experienced peaked immediately as we passed it, and never left till the next morning. I could barely sleep. The next morning, it seemed like the presence had lessened. We began to feel safer. Later on that day, when my friend was leaving, we noticed the car wasn't there anymore. It's been 5 years since then. I've never seen the car or the doll since. Well, Robert, behind you now. Oh, well, hold on, wait, no, sorry, I'm not even there. Okay, I'll see you later, bye.
You're a piece of shit. It's what you are. Oh my God, that terrified me. Well, thank you so much for those stories. Listen, story one, I'm glad you're moving away from those neighbours. What awful people. I cannot imagine how it must feel knowing that somebody was in your house. Somebody who wasn't you or your family just marched into your house and was like, this will do, I'll set up my murder apparatus here. It makes me wonder, right? Because things like, I'm talking about a second story now. things like dolls that are literally just objects, right? What makes us have that feeling of that doll as fucking is a ghost? What makes us think that? I get sort of the same things with some mirrors. Mirrors, I'm like, I'm not touching that mirror. But what I wonder what gives us that feeling. It'd be nice to know from skeptic and non-skeptic point of view. I'm gonna mattify my skin because I'm trying to be like dusty. A little bit of shine is okay. Oh, honestly, that scared the shit out of me. Okay, so we have another story, and this is called Costly Training Institute for Orphans. So it says, hi Robert, my name's Casey and I'm from New Zealand. I recently started watching you and you're such a funny and cheerful person. I love it. Thank you so much. This story took place when I was 17. For one of my photography assignments at school, I chose to travel up to Auckland from Hamilton, where I live, to visit an old building that has had a tragic past and to take some neat shots of. The name of the place was called the Charlie House. It was built in 1886 and formerly known as the Costly Training Institution for Orphans. Many myths surround it. The most disturbing is that 43 young boys died from smoke inhalation during a fire in 1912. The fire was supposedly started by a neglected candle which spread to the curtains and ravaged through the dorms, a tragedy in the truest sense. The land itself is tainted by the traumatic events that took place, and the building's rotting walls will always be scarred by the terror, death, and anguish from within. The tortured souls of the children are fabled to still stalk the hallways. As my brother and I arrive at around 12 a.m, we found it surrounded by barbed wire fencing, which was disappointing, but what can you expect? I started taking photos and this weird man arrived. He was acting very strange. He was looking after the place, I think, and was probably worried we would try and break and enter, but he had an off vibe. I took my photos of the front of the house, and we drove around the back of the place. One thing to note is that Charlie House is permanently closed and is not safe to walk through as it's very old. Both my brother and I swear we could hear footsteps and chatter from behind the walls of the house on the second story, but it was faint. We thought it was kind of cool, but then headed off back home after the shoot. When I went to review my photos, I spotted something odd. There were two photos I've linked, which look very similar, and that's because they are. I took both of these photos milliseconds after each other. As you can see, there's this weird, almost skeleton spine thing. I promise these have not been edited, and were taken quite literally milliseconds after one another. Not sure what this thing is, and I've owned my camera for many years, and never ever has something come up like this. What do you think? Ooh, I don't know, let's look at the pictures. Creepy picture off the wall. Ooh, I'm scared someone's gonna jump out at me, I know it's not. And the picture taken less than a second afterwards. Oh yeah, I see. Do we zoom? Can I zoom? Yeah, that is it does look like a spine bone. Almost like you did just capture the backbone of a ghost. I wonder what that weird man was doing there. I know like some homeless people sometimes live or like squat in abandoned buildings. It does look like a spine. I'm trying to think a bug, but then it would have a full trail. It doesn't just like appear and then no longer appear. Disappear is the word I'm looking for. So there used to be an abandoned, that is so strange. You know what? There used to be this abandoned like cul-de-sac near where we grew up as a kid, and we used to go there all the time. And thinking about it now, where I live would be built on that abandoned place. I just thought about that. That's so strange. how times, I don't know what I'm saying. But we used to go there all the time, and there's something about abandoned places, even if they aren't like, it wasn't necessarily creepy or ghostly, but they were like normal houses. But I think it's like what we consider something normal in our everyday lives, like a house looking so abandoned and looking so, it's just abandoned. It makes it really, really creepy. And it wasn't like just a few houses, it was a whole street of houses. And you weren't actually meant to go in, but we always found a way around the back. Listen, when this pandemic is over and we're all okay to carry on life as normal, I need to go on like a ghost evening hunt thing. So I'm going to kind of contour so I look a bit grey. So I'm going to use literal grey, and I'm going to read the next and last story. It's gone so quick today. I didn't have as many audios as usual, which is fine. I have two more stories. So this story is called The Crying Ghost. Why do I have to cry? Hey Robert, I'm Nurse Lady. Oh, hey Nurse Lady. I've been wanting to send you my ghost story, but I just moved to the UK and it's been an adjustment, I can imagine. This happened to me a long time ago. Back in high school, a group of friends and I were assigned to perform on stage for a school program. Since we only had a few days to prepare, we decided to practice as much as we could and would stay until 8 p.m. school. That's a long time to stay at school. One night, while we were just about to finish our practice, I suddenly heard a young girl crying loudly. Even with the music playing, her cry was clear to me. I noticed none of my friends reacted, so I decided not to say anything to avoid scaring them. No, get them involved. However, one of my friends suddenly paused and exclaimed, "Turn off the music." As one of my friends did so, we watched him pause and listen attentively until he said, "Did any of you hear that?" Then I asked, "The crying?" "Yes, of a girl." All of our other friends said they didn't hear a thing, especially since the crying stopped along with the music. The song had no glitch because we had played it several times and no crying could be heard. We knew that we were the only ones at school at that time, aside from the male security, so we hurriedly grabbed our bags and ran out of the campus. The following day, when we told a few of our other classmates of what happened, we were informed that a young girl once killed herself in the classroom where we were practicing because of her failing grades. That is so sad. Thank you so much for that story. Okay, my battery just ran out, so if I look different, it's because it's a different time. What was I going to do? I forgot where I was. Okay, so we have one more story, which I'm going to put on my lashes too. This is called, it doesn't have a name. I'll name it before reading it. Very spooky for my time is the name of this story. Very spooky for my time. Okay, so it says, actually, there's no way I can do mascara without looking in the mirror. So it says, the video attached was taken by my best friend's neighbor's outside security camera. Backstory. Her daughter woke up at 4 a.m. screaming and terrified. The family dog was going nuts, thinking that perhaps someone had tried to break into the house. They checked the camera footage and this is what they saw. Also note, the ghost, decoration seems to be very slowly moving, yet the plant on the bottom right doesn't seem to move at all. So it seems there was no wind that night at that time. Also, this is a quiet residential street. There's no traffic. What do you think? Thanks for reading. Love your face. Thank you. Let's have a look. Oh, I'm a little bit scared now. Okay. Oh! That really scared me. Let's do that again. The ghost is like puffing up, right? Yeah. And if that was like wind, like a breeze, surely it would be like, you know? I don't know. I love stuff like that. Thank you so much for sending it in. I have no idea what to think about that, like what that would be or what it could be, or why the ghost thing is slowly rising. It's very strange. And like you said, there's nothing else going on anywhere. Really weird. Thank you so much for sending that in. That is the video. This lash is now coming off. Thank you so much for joining me this week. Like I mentioned before, if you have any ghost stories, any of what I said before, send it right here to this email address. Please look after yourself this week, both physically and mentally. Thanks again for joining me, and I will see you very soon. Bye.